Well, hey, y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton, and I want to compare today what's better, a free or a paid theme for your WordPress website. Since the beginning of time for WordPress, people have asked that question, should I pay the extra $30, $40, $50, $60 for a theme, or should I just try a free version? So we're going to talk about that today. I show you a couple ideas that might help you out. I want to give a shout out though to these awesome three incredible companies inside of the WordPress world. WP Engine, if you're looking for hosting, check them out. They know their stuff and they only host WordPress websites. So when you're ready to need some help and call in for support, they're your team. Then if you're looking at WP Elevation, if you're an entrepreneur trying to grow your brand or build websites for a living, check them out. They're going to help you better understand how to position yourself inside of the WordPress world and how to sell to clients. And of course, WP 101, if you love tutorials just like this and you want to nerd out on learning WordPress even more, check out their library of incredible videos. Their team over there have some really cool free options as well as a paid subscription that is so worth the money. So let's get into it and talk about free versus paid. When you're looking at your WordPress dashboard and you're going through here and kind of looking at things, you've got an option here for themes. Go into themes and you can search. Let me pop off over here so you can kind of see. You can search add new if you wanted to. Click add new and go into this library here. And all of these are going to be free options for you. Now, if you're saying to yourself right now, I can't see this area, or I don't have that many options, or this space looks different, it might be that you're using the WordPress.com version of WordPress. This video specifically speaks to being able to buy a theme from an outside source and upload it here. And the only place that you can do that is on the .org version of WordPress. If I'm already confusing you, I've got a video that'll help you understand the difference between WordPress.com and WordPress.org, and I'll put that in the description box below for you. But today, talking specifically about WordPress.org version means that you've hosted the website on a hosting company like WP Engine, GoDaddy, HostGator, any of those guys, and you're able to go if you wanted to and purchase a theme and install it. Well, these right here are the free themes that you can use. And of course, there's a ton more where that came from. You can use the filter option to come in here and check out and go look at all sorts of different themes. There's hundreds, literally, maybe even thousands of themes that you can choose from. So why would a free theme be great? The first thing is, it's free. So that's always in the budget, right? The next thing is, they are really going to be pretty straightforward, clean, and simple. They're not going to have a whole lot of crazy bells and whistles. They're going to be pretty straightforward. The other thing is that people have a concern about, though, is, yeah, but since I'm not paying for it, am I going to get the type of support that, you know, I'd like to get if I have help, if I need help? Well, the truth is a lot of authors out there will give help for their free supported themes. So if you're looking for help and you can't figure out how to do it, a lot of authors will give you an area to go to a support form, fill out a form, connect with them, and get that feedback and get that help. A lot of them also provide an upgraded or a pro version that you can pay for to get the extra bells and whistles that you might see in a demo. So just be aware of that. Know also that a free theme could potentially, though, no longer be supported by their author, as could a paid theme, but it's less likely, especially if the author is making a lot of money on it. But if a free theme, an author gets inspired to do a different version of a theme, or they just see that this theme really isn't being used a whole lot, that author could, in a sense, abandon that theme and it no longer gets updates. What that means for you is that if you're using that theme and something starts to break on it, you might not get the support that you need and you would have to change your theme to keep your website working well. One of the things you want to look at, of course, is as you're looking at any theme, you want to open it up and take a look at the reviews and be sure it's got great reviews. Be sure that it's fully responsive, right? So it looks great on a cell phone. And just make sure overall that you like the features. You think your logo is going to look great in that space and it has a nice menu for you for all the different menu options you're going to need. Just keep that in mind as sometimes a free theme can be a little limiting. With that said, my favorite free theme right now, as of 2016, is Xerif Lite. I'll put the link to this in the description box below as well. And next week, I'm going to come out with my top 10 favorite free responsive themes for 2016. But that's a little sneak preview of one of my absolute favorites. As for purchased themes, the other thing you can do with a purchase theme is to come in here and upload a theme. So if you've gone to some other supplier who has WordPress templates or WordPress themes, you can purchase a license to use that theme for one website. And one of the most popular places on the market is themeforest.net. And their best-selling theme right now for WordPress is Avada. It has been for some time now. It is extraordinary. We've done several videos on this particular theme. But with this particular theme, and with a lot of paid themes, you know, this one is a $60, $59 US dollar theme. A lot of times what you're going to get is option overload. And sometimes that's so overwhelming that you can't really figure out how to set up the theme to actually get it looking like the demo that you saw, because there's just so much you have to tend to. So be aware of that. Is a free theme better than a paid theme? Sometimes it is. If your budget is less, then go with free, just to get a proof of concept out there in the market, right? To get familiar with WordPress and how plugins work and widgets work, just to kind of get your senses around the whole idea of building a WordPress website. Then you can go out and invest that $60 one-time fee and be able to use that on one website if you wanted to. A couple other themes might run as low as $40, $30, and they go up from there. I've seen some themes run $200, $300. Again, that should be a one-time fee, but that only applies for one website. Avada, by far, is one of our favorite themes. I have a great gal here at San Antonio and our WordPress meetup group that loves the X theme. Shout out to Bernadette. Hello. And we've got all sorts of other things here. Bridge is a pretty great theme. There's one called Austin that's pretty great in here, too. But what you want to look here is the same thing that you're looking at when you're looking at a free theme. What are the reviews? You can go in here and search specifically into Avada. You can see the comments here and kind of see what people are saying about the theme. How quickly, you know, if somebody was asking a question 5 hours ago, how quickly did the author respond, so you know that they're attentive? You know, if this gap is 5 days or 10 days or they're not responding at all, you probably don't want to purchase that theme because you won't get the support that you're looking for. So as long as people are responding quickly and people's overall comments are excited and supportive and saying that it's a great theme, then you know, go for it. Make the investment, dive out there, and figure out how to set it up. A lot of times, these premium themes also have outstanding documentation so that the author will give you a step-by-step tutorial on how to set up a theme. And those types of assets are typically more common in a pro version or a paid version of a theme versus a free version of a theme. So I hope this kind of helps you weigh out in your brain. You know, should I invest? Is it okay if I just go ahead and stay with a free version? It absolutely is okay. Unless you're needing some crazy bell or whistle or some crazy outstanding weird look that you can't find in a free version, then you might have to upgrade and go with a pro version. Or upgrade even higher and go with a custom-made theme. That's what we do here at WebTegrity. We build out fully from scratch custom themes around your brand or your needs. So there are companies around the world that can do that for you as well. I hope this helps you kind of weigh it all out, and I hope you're having a great WordPress Wednesday. I will see you next week. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. If you have a question, will you leave it in the description box below or tweet it to me so that I can maybe make a video for you? I'm always looking for ideas. Have a great one. Bye, y'all.